More than 50 years after Jackie Robinson changed the game, we are still awaiting the gender barrier to break through in Major League Baseball. Ila Borders attempted to do so, trading now in her glove and ball for a hose and an axe.
Hey, please welcome Ila Borders. Come on now, talk to us. Ila.
From the Tonight Show with Jay Leno.
Chances are you have never heard about Ila Borders.
To 60 Minutes with Mike Wallace. She's even a newsmaker in Japan. Ila Borders, the queen of the hill in the early 1990s.
I had like 71 interviews in 3 days.
The 5'9" lefty with a ponytail under her cap was the first female to earn an NCAA men's baseball scholarship at then Division II Southern California College, now known as Vanguard University.
I had a good changeup, good screwball, good curveball, and threw the ball 83 with movements.
From college to the pros, Borders became the first woman in professional baseball since the Negro Leagues with her 1997 debut for the Independent League St. Paul Saints. After being traded to Duluth, she became the first female winning pitcher in the pros 20 years ago.
They kind of say it's double A pitching, high A ball, almost double A hitting. Mike Vick, he is my branch rookie.
The Saints were owned by eccentric promoter Mike Vick and actor Bill Murray.
As soon as they saw my work ethic and that I love the game and I can help win, they were like, we want you, here you go.
The majors weren't calling, so at the age of 25 in 2000, Ila went in search of another career.
Maybe if it was now and if I was playing now, I'd get that opportunity. But it wasn't there at the time. I have no regrets.
Then a pair of tragic events changed the trajectory of her life.
I lost my grandmother to drowning, lost my partner to a drunk driver. It took me 6 to 7 years to recover.
The game of life put Ila into a deep counter depression, but she battled back and now gives back.
It's created a lot of empathy. This job and going through that depression time and thoughts of suicide and making it through and seeing people on their worst day, it kind of changes your outlook on life.
A new life in Oregon came calling, now 43 and married again. Relocating from Phoenix, Borders is on the beat in her third year as lieutenant and paramedic for the Cornelius Fire Department.
There's so many similarities between firefighting and baseball. You gotta work as an individual, but you're still part of a team. Working out every day, getting along with each other, and then it's a sense of family and then service, and you get paid to help people.
While it's life around diamond plating now, the dusty diamond will forever be in her blood, and she'll never be forgotten in baseball's Shrine of the Eternals.
There were always some naysayers, it was pretty rough, but there was always the right person at the right time to help me out.
Ila has lived a remarkable life with many chapters to come. She felt compelled to put it all down in a memoir released last year, titled Making My Pitch, A Woman's Baseball Odyssey.
You're not getting into this job to be rich, but you do. You go home at the end of the day and you feel like you made a difference.
While still coaching high school and college area kids, Ila is remaining in the game. She'll play in the Women's World Cup this August. She's also scheduled to throw out the first pitch for her beloved LA Angels next month, something she also did more than 20 years ago. Ila is also in charge of the volunteer recruitment program in Gaston, Forest Grove, and Cornelius. They could always use a few good women and men. In studio, Nick Krupke, Fox 12 Oregon.